Hi, ladies and gentlemen, this is Shera Inspires speaking to you from Nairobi, Kenya. Remember, my videos target men as a wife, as a mother to three sons and a daughter. I know that there's hope for our men out there, especially now that the woman is so greatly empowered. I have challenges personally as a married woman and many other young girls who speak to me who are in relationships and in courtships. Because guys are so evasive, guys are so non-committal, and ladies don't know where the relationship is going to. Guys, why is this so? You may be in a relationship, you meet a girl, maybe through a dating app, and finally you decide it's time that you're going to have a face-to-face. When you meet this lady, maybe you get intimate, and after that, you just become evasive. You don't call. You call maybe once a week, and you used to call like every day. And remember, these ladies also, they want you to come out straightforward and say, I want you just for a good time. I want you for seriousness. I want you for marriage. Because ladies also, they may be looking for the same. Guys, have you ever thought about that? Remember, the olden ladies suffered so much under men, so they didn't really have a say, but not the girl now. There's so much information out there. Guys used to go home looking for girls from the village, thinking that they are less informed and the girls in the cities were more informed, but times have changed because of media. So guys, please just be very clear on what you want in a relationship. Do you want her for keeps? Do you want her for a good time? Do you want the relationship to lead to marriage? You cannot be evasive. Does it mean that, guys, you really don't know yourselves? You don't know who you are? And I feel that you should start by discovering who you are. I do a lot of teaching on self-discovery, and I feel it's important. Girls also, and young ladies, talk to me. They're in courtship with a guy. You date somebody's girl for a year, 2 years, 3 years, some even five, and you don't even marry her. And yet you're getting intimate. Why would you want her to behave like a wife and you a husband and you're non-committal? Girls want to get married, but men, don't you ever want to get married? It's a challenge when you say that there are no girls to marry these days. They are all going for men with money, but it is not true. You are so wishy-washy. You are indecisive. You're not sure what you want. And the ladies are getting confused. I told you I'm married too. And yeah, there's a bit of confusion in the marriage as well. And I talk to married women too. So men, why can't you just come out clean? If you're tired of a relationship, come out openly and say that this relationship is going nowhere. Don't you have sisters? Don't you have nieces? Don't you have mothers? Why would you want to protect your sister and yet you want to treat somebody else's sister in a nasty way? Why would you want to marry a girl who does not have a child, who has never been in a relationship, in fact, preferably maybe even a virgin? And what about you? Have you been protecting women, or you've been moving around with them, but when you want to marry, you want to marry the best? So who will marry all these girls who have babies? Reminds me of an olden song that goes like this. Now a man will take a good girl and ruin her reputation, but when he wants to marry, well, that's a different situation. He'll just walk out and leave her to do the best she can while he looks for an angel to wear his wedding ring. Where are you going to get an angel? Have you been an angel yourself? Men, don't always point a finger at someone. Oh, you're the one who's not been calling me. Oh, you're the one, you girl, you're the one who doesn't know where the relationship is going. You're the one who's non-committal. Oh, you know, I've been busy. Why can't you come out clean? If you're busy, say you're busy. If you have traveled, say you have traveled. But these tactics are a bit old-fashioned, and they were used by your forefathers, your grandfathers, and they're obsolete. They won't work now. Not with the current woman. She's empowered, she can drive, she's got a car, she may be having a better job than you, a better car. So what you need, guys, is to up your game in terms of love. Don't just point this one finger at someone, at the woman. It is you. Have you ever thought of turning this finger inwards and ask yourself, Could I be the problem? Me, the man, am I the problem? So please, let's hear your views. Let's hear how you're handling it from your area, from your region, from your country. And your positive and negative feedback is well appreciated because it builds me. Asanteni and clouds of blessings.